And we are at halftime here at the Schaefer Center. Lions down 41-22. And looking at some of the stats, John, it's been all Rams in almost every team and individual category. A field goal percentage is where you were guessing at halftime. You guessed 25%. It wasn't even that good. It was 21%, 21.8% to be exact, for Lady Lions. Meanwhile, Lady Rams at 55%. As you see there from three-point land, John, 11%, 1 of 9 for Lady Lions. 38, I got a good percentage for 3 for the Lady Rams. Free throws, 80%, 77%. Rebounds, pretty close, 2019. But, boy, you talk about domination in a lot of areas. Even points off the paint, 18-6 in favor of TWU. Bench scoring, 16-4 in favor of TWU. Points off turnovers in favor of TWU, 12-8. It goes on and on all the way. A great first-half performance from Texas Wesleyan.
Well, it was no mystery. If you watched it, you could easily see the discipline of the Lady Rams just were out, it was outweighing what SAGU was bringing to the table. So Lady Lions have to go in, they have to dig deep and come out a little more disciplined. One of the good signs that you could see is that they didn't get beat out on turnovers.
Right.
So they were a little bit just shy of the Lady Rams turnovers was 10-11.
10-11, that's correct.
And that's a good sign, especially considering they were probably averaging 15, 16 and a half. They've cut down the turnovers. They just have to get the ball in the bucket. Really, that shooting percentage is the almost tell-all. And they've had some tremendous looks and some tremendous opportunities they've just not followed up on and converted. You just have to convert those buckets to points.
27 of Texas Wesleyan's 41 points have come from two players, Easley and Parker. They've got 13 points and 14 points each. Easley 13, Parker 14. Meanwhile, balance scoring for the Lady Lions, just not enough scoring. Hill with 2, Rodriguez with 5, Croc with 2, Cox with 4, Page with 5. So you're seeing a lot of players score, just not enough abundance at all. So wait to see what happens here in the second half of play. We're about a minute and a half away, and we'll take one more quick break here. We'll be right back with second half action on the SAGU Sports Network. As we take you to break, we look at our, quote, competitors. Apparently the ESPN folks are in town covering the game as well. So we got some work to do, John. We've got to get our game face on as the ESPN commentators, pseudo-commentators are on the court. We'll be right back after this quick message from our sponsors. We are back. Second half of play is underway here. Schaefer Center, Lady Rams with the ball and drilling it from three-point land. It's Stacy Darnley. She's got 9. Here comes Hill over to Page. Same starting 5. Rodriguez getting the start tonight. And ball is wide open. It's going to be, well, I guess it was tipped, John. So Page able to pick it back up again. Rodriguez from 3. She already has 1 3. That one's short. And here comes Amy Easley on up ahead. Back to Easley. Looked at the 3. Now over to Sims. No Lisa. Back to Easley. 44-22. Doubled up the Lions score. Long 3 ball from Darnley. Too strong off the glass, but an offensive board will reset the shot clock for the Lady Rams. Good ball movement. Better position inside. Bucket, hoop and a harm. That'll send Caitlin Threes to the line. A nice little 14-footer from the baseline, John. Looked good coming off, and it went down. And your mic's down, so I'm gonna cover for you, my friend. Are you back now? Okay.
We're having a little issue. I'll be back on.
Hill now looking for answers. She's only got 2 points on the night. Rodriguez flashes through the post, works inside. Tough bucket up and in. Rodriguez, nice move off the pass as she curled around the elbow and just worked her way down to the baseline or to the block. Lions got 24. Darnley, check pass over to Easley and a one-arm pass nearly overthrew Darnley inside now to Nolisa. A long ball from Amy Easley, no good, but another offensive glass pulled down by Stacy Darnley. Another shot clock, another possession. And that one's too flat off of Sims, and Kroc would come away with it. On up ahead to Rodriguez, over in the corner to Hill. She needs to hit this three. Too strong, but Cox with an offensive glass will reset for the Lions. Here comes Kroc's turn, spins. Too strong off the glass in transition. Here comes Carnesha Sims, the senior from Tulsa. She goes coast to coast, lays it up and in. Carnesha Sims, a transfer from Murray State College, averages 9. That's just her first bucket of the game, I believe. Extends the lead to 24.
And the Lady Rams are picking up where they left off, Rob. Just strong, disciplined defense, waiting for the right opportunity on offense and converting.
Kroc lowers her shoulder. Tough pass to Rodriguez. Trying for position. Doesn't have it. There's a pump fake crossover. And see, it works, I'm telling you. Just do the fundamental stuff and look what happens. Rodriguez cuts the lead to 22. They need some stops, though, right here early to keep this game within some kind of a reach.
Well, I'll tell you what they need more than anything. More than a break, more than stops, which they do need a lot of stops, obviously. They need the ball to go in the basket. And you can have as many stops as you want. If you cannot put the ball in the basket, it's not going to do you very much good.
Absolutely. Page, strong move, and finally gets the whistle she's been asking for about the last four times she's touched the ball. She'll go to the line. She's only got 5. I think she averages like 9 a game. Let's check that. Yeah, she averages 8 a game. Actually, they're going to call that on the floor, John.
Yep.
Stand corrected. I thought she was going up for the shot. Rodriguez fires up a 3-point bomb. It looked good coming off. And cycles out. Threats rebound on up ahead to Amy Easley. She may go coast to coast, drop step, euro step. Offensive glass rejected by Page, pulled down by Kroc. On up ahead to Hill in transition, and she misses the easy layup. She slowed down going up, I think looking for a little body contact, and just took it too strong off the glass, John.
Yeah, she definitely was trying to fill out what that defender was going to do and then allowed it to slow her up. It's a good pass, good inbounds pass, Charity Page.
Tough shot. Off the no-look bounce pass out of bounds. I like how Hill was looking straight ahead and threw to her right. She saw Page with position and a tough shot inside. Lead back to 20. Nolisa over to Easley. Sims now back to Easley. Looked at the three, takes Hill inside. Now nice pass inside and doesn't fall. Cox wrestles it away from Nolisa. Gyra does a pump fake again, and she gets another one in the bucket. Has two pump fake crossovers, and this time it'll send Gyra Rodriguez to the line to try to complete a 3-point play.
Well, I love what I'm seeing out of Gyra Rodriguez at this point. She's saying, well, if no one else is going to step up, I'm going to go ahead and try to do this. So hop on my back for a little ride here. And so the last few trips, she's been very aggressive. She's missing her 3-point shots. She's not shooting very good. So she knew. She just said, I'm going to take it down, drop step, pump fake, move under. And that's worked for her several times already this game.
She's got 12. She averages just 4 a game. She's well above her average. And like you said, she's feeling it, and she'll get the ball again for sure. Meanwhile, from the elbow, and that one's a shooter's touch from Caitlin Threets. The 5'11 sophomore gets the friendly bounce.
Caitlin Threets is that 14 points a game solid player that you can count on every time out.
There's a turnover. Too many steps. Rodriguez took the pass at the top of the key and just couldn't quite get her feet set. Lions down 19. That's the number they were down at halftime. Carnesha Sims in the corner, over inside now to Threets. Darnley. Darnley from three. In and out. Cox with the board. Cleared out. Here comes Hill crossing the timeline. Croc crosses over. Rodriguez, she's got the hot hand. Gives it back up to Hill. From 17, no good. Offensive glass, Rodriguez into the paint. Nice bounce pass to Paige. She misses the easy, but gets her own rebound. Puts it up and in. And she smiles as she walks in the court thinking, I'm glad I made that because I'd have got myself pulled.
Actually,
to get that board.
She's laughing and she's kind of in jest to Jyra saying, my bad.
Well, she atoned for her own mistake with her own offensive glass rebound, put it back in. Meanwhile, Darnley drills a three. The senior from Corpus Christi extends the lead back to 20. She averages 14 and a half. She's got 12. Paige over to Cox at the elbow. Croc will try a three. Too strong. Cox with the rebound. Hill, she launches a three. Good! Taylor Hill drains a three ball. She's got five. The lead, 17. 13 and a half remaining. And McAfee and Griffin are set to check in for Lady Lions at the next stoppage of play. Nolisa, now here is a long ball, no good from Swoops. Cheyenne Swoops just checking into the game. Transfer from Frank Phillips College. Junior from Odessa, Texas. Also checking into the game will be Chrissy Parker and Caitlin Bull. Parker's got 14. She leads all scorers. The Norfolk State University transfer. Where's number 20? Playing a great game for head coach Bill Franey. Croc. McAfee didn't start this game. Off the bench now. Over to Griffin. Just checked in, getting her first action. Another three ball from Hill. Too flat. And look who came up with it. McAfee. And she gets twisted and turned and off the glass. No good. Actually short right into the rim. And the glass meet and no foul. McAfee looking for the foul. And don't keep the ball right here though. Fresh shot clock. 30 seconds. Put back in the shot clock. Quick pass to Griffin, loses the handle, and here comes Stacy Darnley. No one in traffic. McAfee too far behind, too easy. Lead back to 19. Darnley's got 14. She's right at her average now. She averages 14 and a half a game. Griffin just checked in. McAfee now, left side, looking for Cox. And that's a loose ball on up ahead. Too strong off the glass. Sims, rebound, Bethany Croc. She's got McAfee in the corner if she wants her. Instead, a foul near midcourt. Cheyenne Swoops whistled for the body in transition as Croc was looking to complete a transition bucket. McAfee will inbound the ball. 12:15 remaining. Lions, like John said, you need to get some buckets to fall in a hurry and keep playing good, strong defense. You don't want to quit. Don't give up. This game's not over. Try to just chip away at it every few minutes. Get a few more points chipped away and see where you're at with about 3 minutes left. Croc from the wing, no good. Long rebound. And they're going to whistle Cassie Cox going over the back against Caitlin Bowl. Caitlin Bowl is a transfer from the U.S. Air Force Academy, originally from Albuquerque, New Mexico, wears number 22, 5'10 junior. Cox's second foul. Wagner checked in now for Lady Rams, and that three ball is good from Amy Easley. Easley's got 16. She averages 7.5. And let's check in now with Adam, who's joined us up in the booth. Adam, you've got a in-game Sooner Athletic Conference update, so let's see how my picks are doing On the ladies' side, it's a three ball, no good. Go ahead, Adam. How are the scores looking in the other action in the Sooner Athletic Conference?
Right now, late in the first half, Oklahoma City holds a 4-3, 37 lead over John Brown. USAO is losing to MacU by almost 20 at the start of the second half.
Wow.
Wayland Baptist is losing to Oklahoma Baptist right now at the start of the second half by about 13. And then Southwestern Christian is beating St. Gregory's at halftime. So my upset pick is looking not likely here today, Rob.
Cox from the elbow, drains it. Good form, good release. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Cassie Cox, she's got six. Lead back to 20. Bowl inside to Parker. Shot no good. Gets her own rebound and fouled. Going up. She'll go to the line. Chrissy Parker. Looks like she was grabbed by either. Yeah, it's going to be actually, yeah, it's going to be on Hill. Just her first foul. Third team foul for the Lady Lions. First free throw is good. Parker's got 15. Wesleyan looking to improve to 6-3, I believe, in conference play. Second one, no good. The win here will keep them in pace with Oklahoma Baptist, who's winning tonight. They're 5-2. Wesleyan's 5-3. And shot from Dorsey off the glass, no good. And here come Lady Rams. Swoops, a lot of speed there. Gets it off to Amy Easley, and Swoops comes away with a tough offensive rebound right in the middle of the glass of the paint. She's got some good speed. Dorsey now off the turnover and just cannot get the ball through. Another tough shot. Dorsey, three shots missed in about 5 seconds, all makeable. Meanwhile, Hill, she says, forget, let's go downtown. Those are easier. Taylor Hill now with eight. After the Lady Lions missed three or four four-footers, Hill takes it from downtown. Lead cut to 18. And that ball whistled. The ball goes out of bounds. We'll keep it right here. St. Gregory's also just has one win in the conference. They're right there with Lady Lions, 1-6, 1-7, respectively. Both in desperate need of a win tonight. St. Gregory's losing, as you heard Adam just tell us. They've had a tough season. They're just 2-14 overall. And a whistle. McAfee driving baseline. Going to be called against Amy Easley. That's just her first foul. And subs in for both. Colbert checks in. Sims checks back in. Darnley checks back in for Lady Rams. Dorsey ends mound. McAfee over to Colbert. Who's going to step up for the Lady Lions? Rodriguez has been playing well. Hill's getting on track now. Cox, basically a free throw, and she buries it about a foot beyond the free throw line. Cox now, she's got eight. Lead cut to 16. Lions will stay in that 2-3 defense. And boy, a point blank shot missed by Chrissy Parker. That's uncharacteristic. She's been really playing well tonight. She's got 15 points. And joining me in the booth now is Adam Ferguson. And I tell you what, Adam, these Lady Rams, they're just keeping the pressure on. These Lady Lions, there's a missed shot from Cox, and she's not happy with herself at all.
Yeah, you can tell down there on the sidelines that Coach Beatles is getting frustrated not being able to beat that full court press like he wants to, especially down by 16 here with just under 8 minutes to go. He wants to be able to push the ball up the court and make some baskets fast.
The Lions stay in that 2-3 defense, and that one is good from downtown again. It's Stacy Darnley. I think that's her third three ball. She's got 17 points. Lead back to 19. Griffin's three ball, no good. Long rebound, Colbert. Tough shot, and Cox able to keep it alive. Griffin drives it inside, cuts it back out to McAfee. She's in trouble. Finds Griffin. Over to Dorsey, reset. 17 on the shot clock. You want to get a good quality shot here. You've already got one offensive glass in this possession. You want to make it count. Griffin turns, spins. Tough shot. No good. Offensive glass. Weak side rebound. And it is Dorsey. She's going to go to the line. And she was in the right spot at the right time. Always going to be on that weak side on those little four-foot jump shots from the other side because they can often miss and just keep going. And right there was Dorsey. Too strong, but she'll go to the stripe to shoot a pair. I should say one and one. Check, that is a two-shot foul. Dorsey drains the first one. Cox takes the seat. Ebony Colbert back into the game.
Let's see if the Lady Lions decide to stick with the 2-3 here next possession defensively, because Texas Wesleyan has been hitting threes, and that's what you want to do against a 2-3 zone. It forces them to take threes, but they've obliged and hit the ones that they've had the opportunity at. So let's see what they do here on this defensive
good
possession.
Good point. Very good point. I'd like to see him go to a man, or maybe just mix it up, maybe a 2-1-2. Just give him a different look. And another offensive glass right there. That's Parker again. She's had a great game. Check that. No, that is no Lisa. That's Oni no Lisa. She averages 11. That's just her first bucket of the game. And, boy, the rim is not being very friendly at all to any of the Lady Lions right now. A lot of good looks and not much is falling inside near close range. Meanwhile, another three ball from Darley, no good. And, oh, wow, that's too easy. Right off of Colbert's hands into the waiting hands of Lady Rams' Oni no Lisa. She's got a quick four. Extends the lead to 21. Griffin now, 15 on the shot clock. Dorsey nearly turned that ball over on the pass to Dorsey. Turns, spins, loses the handle. McAfee with six on the shot clock's got to make something happen. Over to Griffin and overshot everybody, and that ball sails out of bounds. Nice to have John back with me in the booth.
Good to be back. We've been having a little bit of technical issues.
All right, I got you covered.
We're getting them right for the big game tonight.
Well, in your mind, the big game is also Sunday night.
That is the
big
game.
When the Deflatriots, I mean the Patriots.
Hey.
Patriots. Did I say Deflatriots? Patriots play
fined.
The Seahawks.
You're about to get fined, mister.
And
we don't talk that way around here.
Shot clock violation. We'll turn the ball back over to Texas Wesleyan, looking for win number 15 in the season, and looking very much like they'll pick that up here on the road. That could improve to 8-4 on the road. That's a really impressive record midway through Sooner Athletic Conference play, and that one's just too easy right now. Now they're just beginning to run away with it. Now you're talking about a 23-point lead, 5:20, and this game is getting out of hand, out of reach for Lady Lions to try to make any kind of a run. Held to just 45 points so far. Another tough shot. Whistle will send McAfee to the line. I think you hit it right. It's just a game of not making the easy buckets when they were there. There's probably, I've lost count, 10, 11 shots that should have just fallen in that just did not. And that really is the difference in your ball game, John.
Oh, yeah. I haven't seen the shooting percentage yet, but it doesn't look like it's increased too much. You may have moved from 21% to maybe 25, 26%.
Second one's good. That's her first 2 points of the game for McAfee. 21-point lead, 5 minutes left. Now here's a bit of a trap. And Ebony got a handle on that, but they will tip it away just back to Wesleyan. To Sims. Sims now look left, back to the right. Darley, another three ball. And she gets her own rebound off a tip inside.
Getting a lot of long bounces.
Yep.
ball just going the right way. That looked like a travel.
Angela Nguyen.
It was 3 seconds.
And that'll turn the ball over. Angela Nguyen. Angela Nguyen, check that. Angela Nguyen just checked into the game. She's a sophomore from Carrollton, Texas, out of R.L. Turner High School.
Rob, have you ever seen anyone come back with 4.5 minutes left in the game? 21
yes.
points.
Yes,
up.
In football, the Colts versus the Bucks. Exactly, 21 points down with 4 minutes left. Thanks for bringing it up. Exactly our situation here. 4 minutes left, down 21 in 2003. My two favorite teams, which it's hard to even watch the Colts play the Bucks because I love them both. And my beloved Bucks fell to my other beloved Colts in the most amazing comeback ever in fourth quarter history with 4 minutes left remaining on Monday Night Football as Tony Dungy beat his old team. And there's a jumper right near the free throw line. Dorsey makes me forget about the memories of games gone by.
And I'd like to apologize to all of our viewers right now for that broadcasting train wreck brought to you by Rob Price. I am so sorry because I did say basketball.
You never said basketball.
I said
basketball. No, you did not.
It's on the record.
No.
It's on the record.
Play the tape. James Lex, our man, can play that back. You just mentioned 21 points with 4 minutes left, and I interrupted you.
Have you seen anyone?
I interrupted you.
Come back in basketball.
I don't believe
from 21 points down with now it'd be 19 points down with 3 minutes and 30 seconds left.
Right. To answer your question, no. Sadly, no. I think we're going to have
I saw the great Dean Smith
here.
As the head coach of the North Carolina Tar Heels. Back in the early 80s.
Okay, so this whole thing was a setup for you to bring up UNC. And, you know, I'm looking over here, folks, for those who are not here, his wife's here. She's nodding like, yes, I knew he was going to bring this up. Anything to bring up UNC, the Patriots, whatever it takes, he's going to find a way to ask me a question so he can bring up what he wants to talk about.
Well,
truth hurts, doesn't it? He's speechless. My co-anchor is speechless.
It doesn't hurt, I assure you. That doesn't hurt.
Who were they playing? Cupcake University when they came down from 21 points down with four?
That's funny.
Playing all their subs?
Actually, they were playing Duke.
Really?
Before Duke and Carolina was an actual rivalry. And it used to be the big rivalry. If you're a North Carolinian, which
What are you, like 65 years old?
Yeah, that's,
before Duke and Carolina were a rivalry, they've been a rivalry for a long time.
You're from where?
I'm from Indiana, baby.
Of course,
go
okay.
Hoosiers.
So please don't lecture
Bobby
me.
Bobby Knight, don't even go there because I got my main man, Bobby. Can
don't
back me
lecture
up.
Me on Carolina basketball, buddy.
Bobby Knight. Well, we can go somewhere else at halftime. We'll have a little chit-chat between Dean Smith and Bobby Knight.
Hey, Bobby Knight was great. I first want to say it. I love Bobby Knight. Love Dean Smith just a little more, though.
Just a little more. 3:02 remaining in this ball game. 18-point lead for the Lady Rams. They will get win number 15 and improve to 6-3 and stay in that upper half, John, of the conference standings.
And they deserve it. They're a well-disciplined team. Coach Franey has these girls really tuned up and looking good. I think they're still moving upward, and that's the way you want to be, especially late January and early February. You still want room for improvement and each game to be able to hit your goals of improvement so that when it comes tournament time, you've gotten all your mistakes out of the way, and yep. Now – it's not that you're plateauing, but you've done pretty much all the learning that you're going to do because it's one and done in tournament time, and you need to be able to execute flawlessly in the tournament season.
We'll check on the Wayland Baptist score, but if Wayland Baptist ladies lose and OBU happens to lose, then these Lady Rams will be tied for second place by the end of the night behind the powerhouse OKC, which I doubt they're going to get touched at all. So really, at this point, John, it's a race for second place, and Wesleyan is right there in the thick of it.
Well, they are, and I don't know if you presented those odds to the Lady Rams as just settling for second place being their reality. I think in their minds, they're going to keep striving to get better, keep winning, and go for first place. Oklahoma City is on top right now, but that doesn't mean that they're going to win out. We're still on the first leg of the round robin of the conference.
Right. Amy Wynn drives left in trouble off the trap. Defense now going baseline and unable to put that one in. That was Bria Wagner. Missed a point-blank layup. Nearing 2 minutes remaining. Lions will drop this one. This game out of reach, down by 20. Now Shayna Tanks getting some playing time, and she's off on that three-point shot. Here comes Brianna Wagner. On up ahead, left hand off the glass, tough shot. Liz Handy is handy with that one. And she puts that one through. The transfer from Panola College. She's on the board. Her first bucket of the game. Extends the lead back to 22. So a nice road win here tonight for Lady Rams as we get ready for game two of our doubleheader. And it's going to be a good one, folks.
Well, it looks like you and Adam have gone up on me by one in the Pick'em Challenge, the Guaranteed Win Challenge. And although I had a feeling that the Lady Rams would come in and play very well and most likely walk away with the win, I couldn't let the night go by without a little bit of home.
A little bit of home cooking love.
Cooking love.
And here comes Ebony Cooper. Nice move inside. And just can't get that one to fall. That pretty much sums up the night right there. Although there's a nice follow bucket from Dorsey. But the Ebony Cooper miss pretty much sums up the night. Another good look missed. Dorsey will go to the line. Now, to go back to your pick'ems. We've kind of added some things, folks, to this pick'em night. We were picking just one game. And now,
well,
we
it
decided
was
to just
more,
pick all of the games.
Well, it was more than one game because Adam Ferguson decided to just go chalk on all his picks. And, well, you know, we can't have that.
No. So we made him pick all five games.
We put some fencing around.
Yeah.
Now we have a little structure.
You got to pick every game. Does my two broadcast partners and myself, not just one. You get to pick all five games. We'll keep track. So the numbers are going to increase pretty quick. You know, last week it was like 4-0 for Adam and 2-2 for you and me. Well, those numbers are going to rise up real fast. You figure five games every time we're on the air. So we'll keep track of that for you. And you can make sure you can tweet us your guesses as well, your Sooner picks, your guaranteed wins in the Sooner. We'll see how we all do using the Twitter feed. And there you see. Well, there you look at our graphics, guys. They've got all kinds of things going on here. So let's take a look at this. Oklahoma City versus John Brown. Me and Adam, we just lost our graphic there. Let's go back to the graphic if we can. We all picked OKC, and, of course, the men, Baldy and I mean, John Cookman and I, my buddy, we've got the same picks, and Adam's flying solo on that one. We'll show you more of that graphic in just a minute as we are nearing the 28-second mark in a nice, solid win for the Rams. They're going to win this game easily. The lead is cut back to 15, but it's going to be too little too late, a turnover here. You see some of the same picks. We all picked Mid-America for the women. We all picked Oklahoma Baptist. St. Greg's, Adam, you're on your own on that one. I think you're going to miss that one too, buddy. And looks to be the final possession for the Lady Lions. Shayna Tanks fires up a three. No good. And Lady Rams will be content just to probably run the clock out on this ball game. And they'll do just that. And your lady, well, there's a shot just for the fun of it. No good. And your final score, 72-57. A convincing win. This game really was out of reach by about the 8-7 minute mark in the first half when the Lady Rams just surged ahead. It was 12-12, if you remember, John, with 12 minutes in the first half.
That's right.
By halftime, they had gone on a 29-10 run and really never looked back from that.
And that's what good teams do. They come in after the initial nerves wear off. They begin to just wear you down with their fundamental great play. And Coach Franny has these girls really looking good heading into the second part of conference season.
As you see the team's highlights, some of the better moments of the game as the players on the court gather for prayer. And some good looks inside. You see Paige there, nice bucket inside. And, boy, the Lady Rams are on fire from three-point land. You see another one fall. And they just had it all going in the first half and continued on the second half. Cox had a good night early on. And here's some of your game stats now. Field goal percentage, John, they went from 22 to 27%, well, 28%. But, boy, look at the Lady Rams. They kept it right there at 45%, almost nearly 50%. Three-point land way out in front of the Lady Lions. Free throw percentage pretty close. Rebounds. More for the Lady Lions. You had a lot more with Page and Cox. Pulled down a lot of rebounds, but it was just too much scoring. Goes back to your point. That rim was just too tight. A lid on that rim there.
It really was.
But the Lady Rams, or Lady Lions, as the men have now taken the court. And we'll take a quick break here on the SAGU Sports Network. Game two coming up. Game one, 72-57 in the books for Lady Rams. Stay with us. We'll have more right here on the SAGU Sports Network.